Here at Park Tool, we like to put a lot of effort and thought into what we write and what we present. So when there's a lot of different procedures that you have to cover, we have to go through it and think of what order it's going to be. Now, as bikes change, the techniques change, and the procedures change, and the teaching also changes. An example of this is our new derailleur adjustment procedures, which differ a bit from some traditional procedures taught in shops and even some manufacturers. So let's look why we did that. Let's go back and begin with this beauty right here, a nice friction shifter. On the friction system, it's very direct feel from the lever. Lever's right here. We pedal, we pull, 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 and we pull all the way, and it makes the shift or doesn't make the shift, but it's a very direct feeling from the lever. You know if the linkage is touching the limit screw. Very simple, very easy to adjust. You may be wondering, if you've never seen these bikes before, a friction shifting bike, how do they adjust those gears in between? Well, there's a device for that that's over here. What this device did at the bike shop, you could think of it as an app that programs the onboard computer, the customer. So the mechanic was basically done. It's now the salesman's job to take this device and teach. Well, sir, when we're riding our bike, we're going up a hill, we pull the lever down and it's an easier gear. And there's a funny noise, you back off a little bit. So the adjustments are made here at the lever. That's how you get your 10 gears and you get rid of those funny noises with manual settings. Okay, nowadays we have the modern click, click, click. The mechanic's got work to do. Let's have a look at teaching and what the modern indexing bikes are about. The modern indexing bike is a wonder. You pedal, you push this lever, it goes tick, tick. It goes up 1, 2, or 3 as you like. Everything seems good. It is good, but for the mechanic, setting the limits can be tricky because the indexing feature can hide limit screw problems. Everything here seems just fine under indexing. But let's go back to our friction mode. We're going to simulate that here by actually pulling the cable. We're not going to use the shifter. So here, a good system with exposed cable was to pull it. So we could teach by pulling, 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 and let's do a repeat. Pull. That should scare every mechanic out there. Up and over into the spokes. That's about to twist and rip that off. But it didn't do it on indexing. Because you're not forcing it all the way. So with the exposed cable system, again, we could simulate the friction just by pulling. That's a fine way to do it. We didn't teach that though, did we? That's because of the cable systems that are changing. We are seeing more and more of this. Housing, all the way, solid housing, all the way up into the frame and then out. There is no cable to pull here. So the teaching techniques before don't really work here. So in a video, we need to have something that works for everybody. That's why we're a little bit different. We set our H limit. We then actually set the indexing. Then we're gonna set that L limit afterwards, pushing on that lever to see if it's too loose. So the nature of bikes have changed, the nature of teaching has changed, and the order in which we do things, we've had to shuffle that around for you, our viewing audience. And we hope that that helps. And we'll continue to do this and think things through as we go on here, the Thinking Person's channel, Park Tool. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy Tech Tuesdays, check out our Repair Help video library, which has detailed guides to a wide variety of common bike maintenance procedures. And of course, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest videos from Park Tool.